Thanks so much for joining us here on The Web. A Methuen, Massachusetts man has just pled guilty to human trafficking and possession of fentanyl. The victim telling police that Abraham Jacome was using her addiction to force her into prostitution. The victim not in court today, but the county attorney's office says she never wanted to have any contact with Abraham Jacome again and that he did some time, both of which the judge ordered. Jacome was arrested back on September 30th of last year by Nashua police. Responding to an ad, an officer made contact with the victim who told them all about Jacome. Officers found him in a parking lot at a Nashua motel. And at the time, he had $1,400 in his wallet, and officers found fentanyl in his socks. The prosecution outlining for the court what the victim said happened.
They advised that the defendant forces her to perform sex acts for money by controlling her access to heroin. She indicated that he had made threats in the past with respect to her family. She indicated she did not keep any of the money.
Jacome also received a suspended 1 to 2 year sentence on the possession charge. He'll also have to register as a sex offender when he is released. And right now, the Department of Homeland Security is investigating in 4 New Hampshire towns and a 5th town in Massachusetts. The agency says that it conducted operations in Plaistow, Salem, Londonderry, Exeter, and Haverhill, Massachusetts. Authorities would not comment on the nature of the investigation, but said that there was no threat to the public. We did learn that 2 of these addresses have advertisements on Backpage.com. That website has been the focus of congressional hearings accused of profiting from human trafficking. And new details in a Manchester drug investigation. Police say they've seized more than 300 prescription pills, along with fentanyl, cocaine, and $1,800 in cash from Christina Stratton's car. She was arrested last week after a traffic stop after police say she had crack cocaine, heroin, and more than $7,000 in cash on her. A search of her home turning up even more drugs and cash, along with $5,800 worth of gift cards. And a Manchester woman arrested after police say she killed her roommate's ferret. Firefighters were called to a Lowell Street apartment just before 3 a.m. after someone reported smoke in the building. Fire crews say that smoke was caused by a ferret that had been cooked inside an oven. The owners of the ferret say Ivana Clifford was temporarily living with them. Clifford was charged with 1 count of animal cruelty and is expected to appear in court today.
I cannot wait to get to work as your mayor. Thank you so much.
And history made in the Queen City, Joyce Craig unseating Mayor Ted Gatsis. It's the first time ever Manchester has elected a woman to serve as mayor. Craig taking 53% of the vote, ousting 4-term Republican Gatsis by about 1,500 votes. And voters in 7 cities gave the thumbs up to allowing Keno in their communities to help pay for all-day kindergarten programs. Of the cities with the issue on the ballot yesterday, only Concord, Dover, and Keene said no. And don't forget, you can find complete results from the municipal elections by heading to our website, WMUR.com, or downloading our mobile app. Well, one high fashion label wants you to pay a pretty penny for something you typically toss. Moschino selling this dry cleaning bag. It's a dress, they say, and it's also going to cost you more than $700. The best part is, it doesn't even come with the dress underneath that you see right there. It's actually just a clear bag. The look made its first appearance back in February at Milan Fashion Week. Now it's available at the UK luxury retail site Brown. Site Brown's for $735. Well, starting tonight at 5, a Rumney business washed out by last week's floods, no stranger to high water. Now the owner must decide whether to rebuild again. And it's the season for giving. Help us kick off our annual campaign by helping veterans. That does it for us. Have a great one, everybody.